Hello, everyone. My name is Pranav Murthy, and I am a senior AI/ML Specialist Solution Architect at AWS. Today, we'll be going over how to create, manage, analyze, compare, and track machine learning experiments at scale using Amazon SageMaker Experiments. So let's get started. Before we dive into SageMaker Experiments, let's take a few minutes to understand what is machine learning experimentation and why is it important? Machine learning experimentation is a process of trying different approaches to a machine learning problem in order to find the best one. This involves testing different algorithms, hyperparameters, and datasets to see which combination yields the best results. It is an iterative process that requires keeping track of each experiment and its results. Amazon SageMaker Experiments is a capability of Amazon SageMaker, which lets you create, manage, analyze, and compare your machine learning experiments at scale with ease. SageMaker Experiments is now a part of the core SageMaker SDK, which means you no longer have to install any additional packages to log and track your machine learning experimentations. Today, SageMaker Experiments allows you to log and track your experiments from anywhere. You are able to log and track your experiments from SageMaker training jobs, from notebooks, your favorite IDEs, from studio notebooks, from SageMaker autopilots, and even SageMaker pipelines. With the experiments, you will be able to track who logged an experiment and when, what hyperparameters were used to train the models, which definitely helps with reproducibility, run a qualitative analysis of different experiments in a single view, and select the best model to either integrate it with the SageMaker model registry so you can perform some actions downstream or deploy the model to an inference endpoint to run inference. Today, we have simplified a user's interaction with SageMaker Experiments by asking our users to define just two components at runtime: an experiment and a run. A run is a collection of inputs, parameters, configurations, and results for one iteration of model training. An experiment is just a collection of runs. You can have multiple runs within an experiment, each with its own unique combination of variables. Now you may be thinking, how can I leverage the capabilities of SageMaker Experiments to log and track my current machine learning experimentations on SageMaker? The answer is easy. With just a few lines of code, you can leverage the capabilities of SageMaker Experiments in your existing code base. Let's see how. So in this example notebook, we have defined an experiment name. Let's call it PyTorch Sephartan experiment. Today, experiments SDK is a part of SageMaker Python SDK. So you can import run and load run, which are two main components of experiment, from your native SageMaker SDK. Now, in this example, we create a run called local PyTorch run, and we just log a couple of parameters into it. We log how many training samples we have and how many test samples we have. Along with that, we also log our training and test images and files. And what run.log file would do is it creates a key value pair of your images and labels and uploads the data to an S3 path and associates that within your SageMaker experiment run. So if we do this, it creates a new run and it creates key value pairs for your data set. Now you may ask, how do I find this run? In your SageMaker Studio, if you click on your home, there is a section called Experiments. So if you go to your experiment, you'll be able to see your PyTorch Sephartan experiment. And the run that I just created, if I hit refresh, this is the run that I just created. And you can see parameters such as when it was created, when it was modified, etc. Now, if I open up this experiment, I can go down to input artifacts, which shows me my training images and labels and the S3 patch to it. And if I go to my parameters, you can see the parameter that I just logged earlier, which is the number of test samples, number of training samples, and the value as well. Now, to this experiment run, I want to be able to attach my training metrics such as loss and accuracy. So how do I do that? Let's take a quick look at the actual model training function. In this model training function, I've defined a simple CNN backbone. And in my model training function, I have a function defined as log performance, which is exclusively to log model performance metrics such as loss and accuracy. And with SageMaker experiment run, I can define, I can log my metrics with a run.log metric. And I can choose a name, I can provide a value, and I can provide the epoch value for the step. And I can do this with any number of metrics I would want to. Now, where is this run coming from and how is this run being defined? So if I go down to my actual training function, I define a new load run and a run decorator. And in my load run, I provide the experiment name and the run name that I just defined earlier, provide a SageMaker session, and provide the run to my training model function. And I can use this throughout my code to log metrics and parameters that I want to. I'm also going to log a few additional things, such as what device it was trained on, what were the hyperparameters for training, all of that under a log parameter scope. So here, run.log parameter is going to have the device that I trained the model on and other key value metrics, such as optimizer type that I chose, the epochs that I chose, and the number of hidden channels. I can also use SageMaker experiment run to log confusion matrix at the end of my training session. And I can also log final metrics such as final precision, final recall, and final F1 score. And I should be able to view all of that in my experiment. So if I go back to this, I already have an experiment that I had defined. So let's open that up. So I defined an experiment earlier. So if I open this, and one thing you may be able to see is the metrics that I defined during my training session are presented to me in a tabular view with statistics defined. So you can see that during my training session, the test loss minimum achieved was 0.07, maximum was around 0.14. My final F1 score, you know, the minimum it had reached was 97.68, maximum was 97.68. So it may just be a flat training response. I can see the minimum maximum value for final precision recall. Obviously, it's just one parameter. My accuracy metric at minimum was 95.47, maximum was 97.7. So from the single tabular view, I can see the model is performing pretty well just looking at the metrics. Now, what if I want to visualize some of these metrics? So I can go into charts, and in my charts, it presents me with this nice looking confusion matrix. Now, along with that, I'd like to see how my training loss was performing. So I see a nice decreasing loss, which is good. Now I can switch between compact view and comfortable view to get a more detailed look of my chart. Going back to the experiments. Now let's expand the scope a little more. Now I want to do a basic hyperparameter search for different ranges of hyperparameters. And I want to be able to log all of these training sessions to my SageMaker experiment run. This is a very simple hyperparameter search where I've defined a number of hidden channels. The optimizers vary between Adam and stochastic gradient descent, and my learning rate varies between 1E-3 and 1E-4. And I just loop over each of these combinations of hyperparameters and log the runs into my experiments. So if I go to my experiments and go to experiments at the top view. Now, obviously we don't, you know, we don't want to see all of those runs being run in the session, but I had already generated some of these runs before. So here's one run from that session where this run had a learning rate of 1e minus 3 with an atom optimizer and number of channels defined as 5. So I have a whole bunch of hyperparameter runs. Now I can go into each of these runs, inspect how my metrics were doing, analyze the chart, and go into another run and do the same thing, but that's not efficient. And you know, it doesn't give me a high-level view of how these different runs are performing. So one thing that SageMaker Experiments also allows me to do is select multiple runs together. Here I've selected all my hyperparameter runs and analyzed them at the same time. So here it gives me a tabular view of all of the runs. And from this, I can quickly look at what the final F1 scores are and determine the best performing and the worst performing models. So from this run, I can say probably with a learning rate of this app optimizer and channel size, I've gotten the best performing model at 98% F1 score. My worst performing model for some reason was with stochastic gradient descent and with a much lower learning rate, it only performed at 16. Now, if I'm a more visual person, so I'd like to see this as a chart, so I can go in, select a bar chart, and I would like to visualize the final F1 scores for all of my runs. I can select comfortable view, so I get a more expanded view, and I can look at the metrics right here. So the best performing model is a 98.63, and I can quickly look at the run name and determine what the hyperparameters were, or I can open the run and check the parameters to see what hyperparameters were defined at runtime. And I can also analyze the loss values as well. So I can either select step, wall time, or relative time, but in this example, I'm going to select steps, and I'm going to select the training loss and see how the training loss has been performing. Now, last question you might ask is, okay, so you may not be running SageMaker experiments in local mode. Maybe you're going to kick off a training job. How does that work? The short answer is in a very similar way. When you create a new SageMaker training estimator, you would need to decorate that piece of code with a run decorator, and you define a new run name. I'm calling this train job value, train job with a unique date time value. I supply my hyperparameters and I call fit. So this is going to kick off a new training job for me on MLP2 extra large instance that I've chosen. And if I go back to experiments, it is going to log all those values for me here in my training job. So my training job right here, I do have one defined already. So I can open this up. It is logging those metrics in real time for me. So I can generate the charts just like I did before. I can look at how at step my, let's say, training loss has been performing. SageMaker Experiments also integrates with Clarify, which allows you to generate bias report using a Clarify job, which is also viewable in SageMaker Experiments, as well as get model explainability metrics to get a holistic view of how your model is learning and how it's performing. With that, I'd like to conclude this presentation. Thank you.